A year ago, Kanchana Jindatam lost her leg in a motorcycle crash. She was just 15 and thought her life was doomed. Her boyfriend rejected her, and for a long time, she didn't leave her home in Chiang Rai in northern Thailand. Her mother helps her walk with a new artificial leg. It's made from recycled soda cans and plastic, and although it's tricky at first, it's given her hope. Nearly 200 kilometers away in Chiang Mai, technicians at the Prostheses Foundation are busy making artificial legs. The group has built limbs free of charge for over 20,000 amputees over the past 20 years. Each limb is a sophisticated work of technical and artistic craftsmanship. Legs are molded in sand casts, especially fitted for each amputee. What's even more unique is the limbs are made from 80% recycled materials. The foundation appealed for aluminum that could be made into limb parts. People around the world started sending in soda cans, bottle tops, and rings, and the stockpile quickly overflowed. Instead of smelting the aluminum, they now trade it for top-grade aluminum that's used to make artificial limb parts. Some joints are still made from stainless steel because it's stronger, but most of the leg parts are made from recycled aluminum. The group has started giving limbs to people across Southeast Asia in hopes to spread the technology around the world. Recycled plastics are also a big part of the mix. Most prosthetic makers in the West refuse to use recycled materials. They say they aren't sturdy enough and don't last as long as new materials. But here in Thailand, the process is working. Nearly 60% of all Thais are farmers, so the group designed a foot just for them. It's durable, grips the ground well, and can be worn in water, mud, animal pens, and even climbing trees or mountains. Without donated limbs, many in Thailand are forced to walk with crutches or build their own limbs with wood or bamboo. To make limbs for the masses, the group's founder, Dr. Chirchai Jivakate, had to cut costs. Turning to recycled goods helped him stop importing expensive materials. Before the foundation came up with this technique, artificial limbs were simply too expensive for many.
Most of the amputees that I took care of could not have the artificial legs. The ones who are rich, you know, they can go to Bangkok and get the leg in Bangkok. But the ones who are poor, you know, they have no leg.
Most of the technicians have also lost limbs. They wear their own custom designed legs, and many are keen to give back. For those who get new limbs, it's a chance to gain a second life. 28-year-old Pomprom Rajkiri got her first artificial leg 13 years ago after she was in a car crash. Today she's come in for a tune-up. She says the technicians are unique because more than half are disabled and wear the prosthetics. The adjustment goes well. Pomprom can walk out of the clinic. This act alone is something she and many others like her never imagined would be possible.